Effective from 1st September 2023, US have added some regulation. So if you're sending an SMS marketing campaign, a programmatically coded SMS marketing campaign to the US 10DLC numbers, then it will give you an error of blocked until you take a consent from them if you are collecting your leads through a contact form. So it's a new regulation. In order to overcome that, you'll have to add a checkbox in your contact form. And in this tutorial, I'll teach you guys how you can add a checkbox to your Shopify contact form, and it will be a required field. As you can see that on my screen, so I have this form and here's the checkbox. And if you do not check this checkbox item, the contact form won't go through. Okay, so let me do the test. Okay, now if I hit send without ticking this check mark, you can see it's showing me an error that please tick this box if you want to proceed, right? Now I'll have to check this in order to submit this contact form successfully. And we have been receiving a lot of inquiries from our clients in US to add in checkbox to contact forms of WordPress and contact forms of Shopify. So I thought to create a tutorial for you guys. So if you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to hit the like button so we can understand what more you would like to learn. Okay, so let's start implementing that. Now first go to the backend of Shopify store by navigating to /admin. And that's how the backend of your Shopify store looks like. Click on online store and then click on these three small dots and then click edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to have backup of your theme or create a duplicate by clicking this duplicate. So you can easily have a backup of your theme, and if you add a code wrongly or you don't add the code perfectly, you might mess up with your theme. So you should have a duplicate of your original theme if you're working on a live website. Okay, now let's click on edit code. Okay guys, that's the code editor, and now let's search for contact. And here we have contact-form.liquid file where we will be adding a small piece of HTML code in order to add the checkbox. Click on the contact-form.liquid file. And now I'm going to search for submit. So if you are on a MacBook, press Command F. And if you're on Windows, press Control F. Now let's find for our submit button. And here is our submit button. And that's the div where we have submit button. We will add a HTML code before that div. So let's add a line break. And now copy the code. Don't worry about the code. I'll have this code in the YouTube video description. So there'll be a blog post link in the YouTube description from where you will be able to copy the code. For now, I'll copy the code and paste it above my div of the submit button. And hit save. Okay. Now that's how originally contact form looks like. And once you add the code, which I provided in, and save the file and hit refresh, you will have this checkbox showing up where you can see I have highlighted this website, where ideally you should have the name of your website, right? So within the code, if you look at it, there's a strong tag of HTML where you can simply rename from this website to your own website, right? And now this contact form will not go through if I do not tick that checkbox, right? And let's fill up the name. Testing comment. It's just filling up the dummy information to see if it's working properly or not. Now, if I hit the send button, you can see that it's throwing me an error. Please tick this box if you want to proceed, right? Now, if I tick this box and hit send button, it will send me an email. Or if you are the owner of the Shopify store, it will send you an email, right? And to learn more about A2P 10DLC, I'll add the link in the YouTube description where you can read more about this notice. As you can see that on my screen, so basically it's application to person campaign to 10DLC US registered numbers. So if you are programmatically sending the SMS to US 10DLC numbers, it won't go through after 1st September 2023 if you do not add this checkbox to your contact forms while collecting the numbers of USA. Okay guys, so that's it for this video. I hope you like that. Please hit the thumbs up icon so we can understand what more you would like to learn. And until next video, have a great day.